Pakistan came into existence in 1947. Many of us have spent our childhood in the streets of this country. Childhood memories are very important. It makes us remember the best time of our lives. They shape our thinking and our future. Play is essential to development because it contributes to the cognitive, physical, social, and emotional well-being of children and the youth. How has the play of children changed over time? Gone are the days when watching television was a family affair and smartphones, tablets, or even PlayStation didn't seem to exist in our part of the world. Who can forget the hide and seek? Four square, hopscotch, jump rope, marbles, spud, spin top, and musical chairs. Those were the best days of our life. From bad weather conditions to running noses, nothing stopped us from going out to play in the evening. Or who can forget the board game nights spent with family? Sadly, the onset of technology, all this seems to be things of the past. Experts say playing outdoor in groups help kids learn the art of coping up with winning and losing. If you do not learn this at an early age, you tend to find it difficult to cope with challenging and unfavorable conditions later in life.
My school was an American school, and it had its offices somewhere in Sri Lanka. It was La Sala School. In those days, there were a lot of games. It was one of the basic of a good school. And we had football, hockey, badminton, and lawn tennis, and almost all the indoor games.
Cricket, basketball, all types of game. And I was in the school hockey team. I used to play right away. Actually, games promote your personality. They improve discipline in you. They improve the spirit of competition in you. Then they improve your mental faculties, how to plan, how to fight.
When you play or exercise, a hormone is secreted from the hypothalamus gland in the brain, which is a mood booster. The indoor games such as board and card games or even puzzles are excellent ways to keep the child occupied at home. Not only are these games engaging, but they also help to develop their mental and intellectual skills. Playing games as a group even make them more social.
I have completed Government Girls School No. 1 Multan se apni ibtidai taleem hasil ki. Hum apne bachpan mein bahut maze maze ke khel khelte the jinme gulli danda aur pitthu garam, cycling karna, छुपन छुपाई, भाग दौड़ और इस तरह के बहुत से बचपन में हमने खेल खेले। बचपन में खेलने से सबसे पहली बात तो ये कि इंसान की शख्सियत में खुद एतमादी पैदा होती है और वो अपने आप को बहुत मजबूत महसूस करता है, अपने जो फैसले हैं वो खुद लेने की जो है सलाहियत रखता है और ये आगे जाके आपके लिए एक कैरियर भी बन सकता है।
कितनी बेला से थी।
काश फिर वो
Video gaming is a popular form of entertainment, with video gamers collectively spending 3 billion hours per week in front of their screens. With technology advancements, video games became popular. Computers paved the way for computer games. Motion technology and sensors were responsible for new-age sensor games that involved the physical involvement of that players as well.
The whole sequence has actually changed. We used to believe, or our parents or our school management, they used to believe in outdoor games. But now things have gone to the computer and so many other things. So there is hell of a difference between the two games.
Some games might improve kids' hand-eye coordination and problem-solving skills. Video games that require kids to actually move or manipulate the game through their own physical movement can even get sedentary kids moving, but not as much as if they actually played outside or did sports. Other games don't have such benefits, and violent video games have been shown to increase kids' aggressive behavior. Like a lot of other aspects of raising kids, when it comes to video games, the healthiest approach is moderation. For kids and teens 5 to 18 years, experts recommend that parents place limits on time spent using any media.
Video games, they deprive the children of certain qualities, let us say book reading. Once they get into the field of video games, the habit of reading goes away from them.
So consider setting limits to keep game playing from interfering with schoolwork, household chores, and the physical activity your child needs every day.
जो आजकल के हालात है, मैं सोचती हूँ वो भी कहीं अपनी जगह पर सही है, क्योंकि बाहर जो है वो हालात इतने अच्छे नहीं कि हम बच्चों को बाहर भेजें, लेकिन जो खेलना भागना दौड़ना और लोगों में रह के बच्चा सीखता है, उससे आजकल के बच्चे महरूम हैं। गेम्स और इंडोर गेम्स जो है बच्चे के जहन पे बहुत बुरे असरात मरतब कर रही हैं, क्योंकि एक बटन दबाने से हम गोली चला लेते हैं, 10 बंदों को मार लेते हैं और हम जो चाहे कर सकते हैं। बच्चों के हाथ में रिमोट होता है तो बच्चे अपनी अमली ज़िंदगी में भी वही करना चाहते हैं और वो चाहते हैं एक मिनट में जो चाहें वो हो जाए। मैं चाहती हूँ कि आजकल के वालदैन खुद इंडल्ज हों अपने बच्चों के साथ। घर पे अगर आपके जगह है तो बैडमिंटन कोर्ट लगाएं, लूडो खेलें, कैरम बोर्ड खेलें और इसी तरह के गेम खेलें, ताकि उनके बच्चों में खेलने का शौक पैदा हो।
There is one game which is known as chess. This is the game of the East. Mughal kings used to play this game. I also used to play this game and I was very good in this game. I even play it today also. I would recommend to the children that they should play this game of chess in the childhood.
Actually, now the games are made by the Western experts. They have got their own problems, their own thinkings, their own imagination. And we, living in the East, have our own problems, our own requirement. We need a lot of brain exercise. They are thinking something about space technology and going far ahead of the time. So our kids cannot collaborate between the two. That's the basic problem.
Parents need to be friends with their kids. One should not stop kids from abstaining completely from social media. Instead, online time should be regulated. That's not all. Even experts say that youngsters have a lot of stamina and they need to channelize it into play. Be it a boy or a girl, children below the age of 16 need to play an outdoor sport for at least 45 minutes a day. Don't do this with your kid. Instead, encourage them to play and enjoy a full childhood like you did. Children love to engage themselves in various activities, so give them games instead of gadgets. Encourage them to be more active and inspire them to keenly learn new things. They want to explore and go on adventures, so let them do that.